Welcome to the Fort Hays High School Theater Department's 2021 Play Festival. This afternoon, you'll be viewing our musical theater showcase. This showcase is a culmination of all of the projects that we've done throughout the year, some by ourselves at home, some together in person, some musical, some dance, some improv, and some spoken word. We would also like to, at this time, thank everyone who made this weekend's Play Festival possible. The Columbus City Schools Multimedia Department Specialists, Amy Love, Ryan Van Bibber, Jeffrey Judd, and all of our amazing students and parents who participated. We hope you enjoy our musical theater showcase.
This whole experience has changed my day-to-day routine, and the fact that my routine is so drastically different has changed my motivation when it comes to school. When my schedule included walking around campus, seeing my friends, and sitting in all of my classes, there was a purpose. Go to school, hit every destination, accomplish a task, and go home. But now since everything is at home, everything feels like one continuous cycle. What I loved about Fort Hays was that each day was different, but when every school day is spent in my bedroom, things feel slow and boring. I think I just miss feeling excited to learn in a classroom. I would always look forward to seeing what the teachers would say and how my peers would react. And there's just something very bland about 20 black squares with the names of people I don't know. I really hope we go back soon because I really don't like feeling this way about school.
First and foremost, I would like to say that my habits have absolutely changed for the worse. All of my needling little annoyances have all but doubled under the self-inflicted isolation, and all of my good habits seem to somehow up and disappear. I would say it's because I hardly had to think about regulating them. They weren't any social interactions that I had to deal with that forced me to act normal, so I didn't have to actively think about myself for an extended period of time. So because I don't think about myself, I don't nitpick at all things I do wrong. And because I'm constantly belittling myself, I allowed the bad habits to properly form. Now, on the subject of whether I like these habits or not, I feel as though the answer is very obvious. No. No, I don't like these habits. I've become lazy, crude, and annoying. What little of a social filter I was irreparably damaged, and I've gained this inescapable amount of snark to compensate for my new lack of social grace. I absolutely hate it, and I'd ask for an escape if there was one.
Habits that have changed for me.
I've come into contact with several changes throughout this pandemic.
I would just give up on things.
For example, a lot of my habits have either changed completely or I've created new ones.
When I was in middle school, one of my biggest habits was
caring
what everyone
else thought about me. One habit that's changed is dancing almost 4 to 5 hours every day.
When I got to dance class, I wouldn't want to do
the thing. This is bad because I feel as though I'm missing a lot of me because dance was all I did besides school and work.
So the dancers would just look at me like, what are you doing?
Even when our dance studio did open back up, we could not do that many hours because of the COVID-19 guidelines.
Dance.
I do not like this change because I do not like sitting
in
the house.
When I got to high school,
I miss dancing.
I danced.
I miss performing.
I would do every dance. I would even help come up with dances because I didn't care what nobody thought about me. The reason I like the change of my bad habits because it made me into a better person. It showed me what people think. What people think, follow your dreams and
the
follow who you are.
The changes I made to fix my path were simple.
A big change
art.
Is the shift between my relationship with my mom and dad.
I had to focus on what I had to do because it's not as strong as it used to be. Distracted.
And that's probably because there's just a lot of inner stuff they don't know about. I told my mom about my name
and the way
change,
they turn out.
And she doesn't call me.
They were bad.
It hurts a lot
so
because she's supposed to be my supporter. And she just doesn't want
to
be that. It feels as if she doesn't care about how I feel. With my dad, it's more of him body shaming me. He tells me I either need to lose some weight or tells me to do sit-ups, and it hurts a lot because he is supposed to be my dad and not say such hurtful comments. With me getting distant with my parents, it made me realize that they kind of don't care about my feelings some of the time, and I'm okay with that. I do not mind getting distant with my parents. I do fine mentally and physically without them. Sometimes. I've also noticed I've cut a lot of people out of my life. And it's for the better because most of them were toxic and the other part were just not beneficial to my life or goals. These relationship shifts were a good change, and I am proud of myself because I never thought I could cut someone off without feeling super bad about it. My love life has
the
been
habits
a mess.
I have changed,
but that's because
my
I couldn't
habits,
date.
My study
but now
habits,
I can't.
And the way
and
I
it's a lot easier
mentally.
To find someone I want because I know what I'm looking for in a person after reevaluating
dancing,
all my current
running,
relationships.
Sports.
This year I dealt with an ongoing
by
situation,
what's
and it finally ended a couple weeks ago.
Time.
And I am proud of myself because it
I
was especially hard
think,
to cut this
by
person off.
Positively
and now that
about
I have,
I'm trying not to stress out about a lot.
This year was a
just
lot to handle,
prepared
but I'm
what's
dropped through it. And
really
even
like
though it's still not done,
about myself because
I know
I
that I
should
take more challenges coming
my way. And since this pandemic, I was able to know myself more and just change how I see myself. These days were challenging because we have to meet virtually a lot and sometimes it gives stress and confusion and sometimes it's good because it makes us all safe. At first, I really didn't want this pandemic to happen or virtual learning, but I think it gave me some time for myself to just mentally prepare myself until we actually meet face to face again.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Benjamin Franklin, and today I'll be telling you about my life, the wondrous life that is mine.
I was born the 15th of 17 children. Yes, that many. You can Google it. 15th out of 17. It's a lot. And I only had 2 former years of schooling, so somehow I didn't get that much school, yet I was very smart in my time. I had a talent of being at ease with any tradesman, merchant, European elite, anybody. I could work with anyone. I'm such a people person, not like many people today, but was definitely a people person of my time. I was also a very well-renowned scientist. I did the theory with the kite and the lightning to prove how lightning strikes. I invented the lightning rod that you put on your roof that keeps buildings from being struck by lightning and burning down. I also invented the bifocal glasses, which I'm actually wearing myself right now. And I came up with miraculous time-consuming theories about how the common cold could be contagious, which is what we use widely today with things like strep throat, which really isn't contagious, but I couldn't think of anything else.
Fun fact about me, I love to dance. My favorite song to dance to is the national anthem sung by Demi Lovato, and I will be doing Renegade from TikTok for you. Thank you. I also was a hard-working entrepreneur. I worked very hard for my own fortune and earned it all by myself. I was completely against slavery as an institution. In the earlier days, I was just a little bit racist, but in the end, I realized that everyone is equal, no matter the color of your skin. I also worked to make a volunteer militia so that I could help all the poor people who couldn't afford to help themselves. I also helped establish a hospital for treatment for the poor people who couldn't afford to go to the more expensive hospitals. I died of emphysema when I turned 84. I had been confined to my bed for quite some time because of gout and a large kidney stone. Thank you for reviewing my improv performance. I am sorry that I didn't do a real dance. The only dances that I know are TikTok dances, so I had to do Renegade. But thank you. I hope you enjoyed it. Try to be funny for you. So thank you.
are two ways home, down one long road, one clear path to two conclusions. Does the story end or never end? Does the secret fade or is it everlasting? I could return to my mother like nothing has happened.
Say ah.
get my share. There ain't nothing gonna stop me, cause the moon was there. It all depends on you. So I work real hard each and every day. Now things for sure are going my way. Just to win what I do. Look out, boys, I'm coming through. And I'm almost there. Almost there. People gonna come here from everywhere. And I'm almost there. You know I've had my share, but I've climbed a mountain, I've crossed a river, and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. I'm almost there.
I'm not gonna hold that back up.
On the brake before I even turn the key, before I make the mistake, before I leave with the worst of me. Give them no reason to stare, no slipping up if you slip away. So I got nothing to share. No, I got nothing to say. Step out of the sun if you keep getting burned.
I nailed it this time.